Well, I hope you're having a great weekend. Hope you had fun at the dance. Right now, we're here to present Lesson 3-4, which is on equivalent fractions. And hi, I'm Mr. Gunn, and this is my guest teacher tonight.
Matthew
Russo is going to be helping me out. All right, so tonight we're going to be talking about equivalent fractions. So let's start out by talking exactly what we're talking about when we say equivalent fractions. Okay, so two fractions are considered equivalent. Okay. Let's see, equivalent fractions, if they're what, Matthew?
If the fractions that equal the same amount.
Okay, so two fractions that equal the same amount are considered equivalent fractions. Let's go ahead and write that in. All right. So so how do we tell if two fractions equal the same amount? Well, let's take a look at some examples. All right, let's take an example like 3/8. Okay, this is Matthew's favorite fraction. What are some fractions that are equal to 3/8, Matthew?
30/80.
Okay. And can you tell everybody how you got that? What did you do to 3/8 to get 30/80?
You can just add a zero to
Yeah,
each
and what
one.
Did you really do? You multiplied by what?
10.
Yeah, multiplied by 10. So he took the top and he multiplied by 10, and he took the bottom and he multiplied by 10. What if you did something easier? What if you just multiplied top and bottom by 2? What would you get then?
6/16.
Okay. What if I multiplied by 5? I'd get what? 15 over 40. Okay. All of these are equivalent fractions. Okay. They're all equal to the same amount. If you took a pie and broke it up into 8 pieces, 3/8, that's the same as breaking a pie into 40 pieces and taking 15 of them. Okay. Or maybe you think about a plate of brownies. All right. Now the same thing works on the bottom one. Let's change the colors. Let's do something fun. Let's do yellow. We haven't done yellow in a while. All right, and okay, so if I take 16/18, now this one's a little different. 16/18, we can get an equivalent fraction on this one, not by multiplying, but let's actually try to divide something. What could you divide out of 16 and 18? They're both divisible by what? Yeah, they're both even, so take out a 2. So if I divide the top by 2, I get?
8.
And if I divide the bottom by 2, I get 9. All right, so 16/18 is equal to 8/9. Now, once I get 8/9, I can find other fractions. I could do what Matthew did before. I could multiply by 10 and get 80/90. I could have done that with the original fraction and got 160/180. What else could we do? We could do 8/9 times 3. I would think it was 24/27. And again, these are all equivalent fractions. They all equal the same amount. All right, let's talk about this fraction right here, Matthew. When you can't reduce it anymore, what's that called right there? It's called the...
Simplified
form, or better yet, the simplest form. So if they tell you to take a fraction and put it in its simplest form, basically what you want to do is you want to take out any common factors until it's reduced and you can't get anything more out. So think about what we did last night's lesson with GCF, right?
Yes.
If you take a top and a bottom of a fraction and you look for anything that goes into both of them and you divide it out, well, you've got it. You're going to reduce it down to simplest form. So the idea of looking for something that goes into the top and bottom of 18 and 16 is very similar to finding the GCF and dividing it out. So this actually has a direct relation to last night's lesson. And last night's lesson, when we were talking about numbers that go into each other and we were doing greatest common factors, we were looking for factors, we were using divisibility rules. So you see how all of the lessons in Chapter 3 have kind of led to each other and have built up. All right, so this is one of the kinds of questions you'll see on your practice work on Monday. We'll give you some fractions, and you just have to come up with some equivalent fractions, okay? Now, there's another thing, going back to what Matthew was just talking about with simplest form. Another kind of question is to take a fraction where maybe you can take something out and reduce it to simplest form, all right? So Matthew and I came up with these four fractions for you. What we'd like you to do is go ahead, and just a second, we'll do the first one for you. But what we want you to do after that is pause the video and do the other three, and then come back and see if you get the same answer. And I'm thinking that why don't we do number 3? I think 3 is going to be kind of tricky. So why don't we do number 3 for them? Okay, so Matthew and I are going to do this one. What goes into 25 and 300? Well, look at the last numbers.
5.
Again, divisibility rules. One ends in a 5, one ends in a 0. So take out a 5, divide out by 5. And this is how we show our work. Notice I'm putting a little division sign, and I'm actually showing that I'm going to take out 5. So 25 divided by 5.
Is 5.
And 300 divided by 5, that's a little harder, but it's 60. All right, now, can you take anything else out? Look, they still end in 5 and 0, don't they?
Yes.
So we can do it again. All right, cool. So let's take another 5 out. What's 5 divided by 5?
1.
Okay, and 60 divided by 5. Oop, I forgot to put my divide by 5. Okay. 60 divided by 5, hold on. 5 divided by 5 is 1, and 60 divided by 5 is?
12.
12. All right, and so we get 1/12. And so it took us 2 steps, but Matthew and I did number 3 for you. All right, now you guys pause the video and go ahead and see if you can reduce the rest of the fractions. Okay, so you're looking for a number that goes into the top and bottom and divide it out, and keep doing that until you can't divide it anymore. Okay, and when you're done, go ahead and resume the video, and we'll see if you agree with us. All right, well, welcome back. All right, let's start with number 1. Matthew, what do you notice about the last numbers in number 1, the top and the bottom? They're both what?
Equal. Well, no, not equal.
No, not equal. 4 and 0 are not equal, but they are both even, and that means you can take out a 2. So if we take out a 2 on the top and bottom, what do we get?
2.
2 on the top and half of 30?
15.
Yep, 2 15s. And so if you got 2 15s like Matthew just did, you got it right. All right, the next one, this one's a little trickier. They're not both even, okay? So they're not divisible by 2. But if I look at the numbers a little more closely, 1 plus 5 adds up to 6, and 7 plus 2 adds up to 9, which means both of those numbers are divisible by 3, so I can take out a 3. Notice how I'm using the divisibility rules to simplify these. So let's divide out by 3, and on the bottom I'll divide by 3, and this one's a little harder. The top, you might have to do a little side work. The top's pretty easy. 15 divided by 3 is 5, but the bottom's a little hard. 72 divided by 3 is 24, okay? And 5 and 24, 24 is not prime, but 5 doesn't go into it, so we're done. There's no more common factors. All right, what about the last one, 8 15ths? All right, what goes into both 8 and 15 other than 1? That was a trick question, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, nothing did.
Nothing.
All right? So if you were looking at number 4 and you're like, I don't know how to reduce this, you were exactly right. 8 15ths was a trick question. It was already reduced to simplest form. Sorry, we had to do that to you. So that's the deal, guys. If you're asked to write a fraction into simplest form, you just look for anything you can divide out and reduce it down until there's nothing more that can come out of the top and the bottom. And if they ask you to do equivalent fractions, you just write down one of the fractions, and either by reducing or by multiplying, you just get a whole bunch of fractions that are equal. Make sure that you pay attention to the directions. If it says write 3 equivalent fractions, make sure you actually get 3. But other than that, that's pretty much all there is to this lesson. So we're going to try to keep this one short. So this is
Matthew
and Mr. Gunn saying have a nice weekend. Bye. See you in class on Monday.